during the election. Now that is the bottom line. That is the bottom of the poll. If you have computer skills and other kind of skills that they need, the pay gets higher. But I was at the Board of Elections on Friday, talked to Deborah Cox. She said she sent her information to churches, newspaper, and nobody is responding to any of that. But they're looking for poll watchers. You have to be trained. You have to apply in person at the Board of Elections. You can't do it over the phone. You have to apply in person at the Board of Elections. Their starting pay is what it was, $90. Now it's $120. They're looking for everybody with computer skills or what have you. Thank Dr. Allen.
Yeah, I think Debbie Cox is looking for election workers, not poll watchers.
And you said it was on the page.
Well,
poll watchers.
You don't get paid for watching.
I'm just telling you, she told me.
Yeah.
Well, at one meeting, two or three months ago, I think she was here, and you could sign up for the training and with your availability.
You have to do that in person.
Come down
in person, so not just
sign the thing.
Come down in person with the state ID. State issued ID.
Okay.
Yeah, there is training for poll watchers that's required to be a poll watcher, but they don't pay for that. They only pay for the workers.
Yeah, that's correct, because the training, just go on a computer and take a test. That's all the training is. You and just the computer answering their questions. As Dr. Allen said, by now if you work there, like during the election term, then you get paid. And they have a service schedule.
The form should be back in that back table back there, so you can go on that back table and get all that. But I'm just past what you told me. Anything else?
Motion to adjourn.
Meeting is adjourned.